Indiana Jones at your service, Toad. Ah!
Maybe it didn't sell great, but it was great. Let's take a look at the Kenner Indiana Jones collection. Welcome back to the Junk Room, everybody. It's me, the Junkman, coming back at you with a new video. And I thought, I haven't done a video about the Kenner Indiana Jones line. Now, I've done a video about why didn't kids buy the Indiana Jones line. And there we looked at a lot of the Kenner figures and talked about each one. But I didn't really do a review of the Kenner line. I also did another video, if you didn't check it, of the forgotten Indiana Jones toy line from LJN's Temple of Doom line that a lot of people don't remember or didn't buy at the time it was out, and some other toys from the 90s that a lot of people might have forgotten about. And in that video, we also looked at the planned Series 2 LJN Temple of Doom line that was canceled, sadly. But I've never really sat down and did a review of the original Kenner Raiders of the Lost Ark action figure line. Although the line is based on Raiders of the Lost Ark, it's called The Adventures of Indiana Jones. Before we get started with that, as always, if you want to support this channel, head over to Patreon.com and buy some cool t-shirts like this one right here. Yeah, that's Indiana Jones related. So you might want to pick that one up. Or if you want to support this site in another way, join us over at Patreon. There you get exclusive content, commentary on my videos, sometimes longer cut videos. Haven't done one of them in a while. Videos early, and we're working on more for 2020. So check out the Patreon page. The link's in the description below. Or to buy a t-shirt, go to thatjunkman.com. Now, I've wasted your time long enough. Now it's time to talk about the Kenner Indiana Jones action figure line, figures, and playsets.
Indy, over here. Indiana Jones at your service, Toad. Ah!
Indiana Jones and other action figures new from Raiders of the Lost Ark collection, each sold separately.
Watch him, Cairo, swordsman.
Yeah, watch my swing.
Nice.
All downhill from here, swordsman.
You'll be sorry, Jones.
Tricked you again, Toad.
Indiana Jones, Toad, and Cairo swordsman action figures, each sold separately from Raiders of the Lost Ark collection, new from Kenner.
First, let's look at Series 1 of the action figures. There were four different ones released, and they hit the toy shelves in 1982, almost a year after the release of the film. Hold on, sorry, got a text. Hold on just a second. Sorry about that. Always need somebody. Someone always needs my attention. Okay, let's look. Let's first check this one out here. Let's look at the main character from the line, Indiana Jones. On the card for the Indiana Jones figure, you get a chance to get a free Belloc figure. We'll talk about that figure soon. The Indiana Jones comes with his gun, a whip, and the figure has a quick draw action. Pull the arm back and release it for a quick draw, something Kenner took from its Real Western line. That's a look at Indiana Jones. Now, his legs are a little too spread out, but that makes him able to steal the horse that we'll talk about soon. Overall, it's a good-looking figure, if you ask me. Now, let's look at the only female from the Indiana Jones collection. Oh, hold on. Sorry about this, guys. He already done his video spiel, so nobody watched that crap. Hold on. Give me just a second. Sorry. Now, let's look at the Marion action figure from the Kenner collection. One of the most hardest carded release figures to find is Marion. They were very few produced. Back in this time, toy companies really went light when it came to female action figures. She comes with a removable dress, a monkey, and a clear plastic stand. Exciting. Overall, the Marion figure looks okay, but I wish they went with a different look of Marion. Why they picked the gown dress that she has that Belloc gave her, it's not really something that would get kids excited for a Marion figure. Maybe a figure based on the Marion we first meet at the bar would have suited the figure better, or maybe the Marion that we see in the streets of Cairo would be a better fit. Maybe they should have done a figure based on that. Well, kind of they did, but we'll get to that soon. Oh, sorry about that. Now, let's look at another figure from the Series 1 Indiana Jones collection. And I'm probably going to say that name wrong. I always called him Tot, but I heard later that wasn't his name. It's like Tote or something. Or maybe it's Tot. I can't keep up his name. T-O-H-T, however you want to say it. Let's look at the only figure that ever got released that I can think of doing a Nazi salute. As you can see, the hand on the figure actually has the burn mark of the headpiece to the Staff of Ra. He comes with a removable trench coat, a small pistol that's different from the one that comes with Indiana Jones. Like the other ones we looked at so far, this is a nice looking figure. Now let's look at probably the most popular one of... I don't know what that stuff means. Let's look at probably the most popular next to Indiana Jones figure from this line, the Cairo Swordsman. He comes with a rope that can be removed, one knife, and yes, he comes with that big sword. How could you make this figure without the sword? It's one of the most iconic scenes in the film. Now, these figures all came with an offer to get a free Belloc figure. You had to cut off the proof of purchases, send it out to get Belloc. And it would be Belloc in his robes, like you see at the end of Raiders, his ceremonial robe, I guess they call it. Now, this figure was planned to be released in Series 2, but it never got released on card. There are a few of these that did get out, mostly as a salesman sample and shown off at Toy Fair and stuff. A few of them have made into collector's hands. So if you have this figure on a card, it belongs in a museum. Let's look at the mail-in Belloc figure. And here's Belloc in his robe. No, it's not a bathrobe, although that would be a pretty cool bathrobe to have. And it has a removable jeweled chest plate also and comes with a staff. Although these figures in this line look great, the best thing about this Indiana Jones line were the playsets. If you're a fan of Indiana Jones or Raiders of the Lost Ark or just old toys, and you can, get these playsets. Now, I had two of them as a child back when they first came out, and they were a lot of fun, but they look really great on display too. Sadly, I don't have anything from this line now except for a Belloc and an Indiana Jones somewhere. I would love to get my hands on these playsets again. Let's take a closer look. Oh, sorry again. I keep apologizing for that. IJSV8. I don't know what this guy's even saying. Let's look at the Well of Souls playset. The playset came with two breakable walls, carrying poles to carry the ark, torches, one mummy, 14 snakes. The best thing about this playset is the ark. Let's take a closer look at the ark. It's amazing detail for a toy of this line. Also, if you're a fan of Star Wars, you'll notice there's something hidden on this toy. Like in the movie, 3PO and R2 are on the wall. Well, here they're not on the wall, they're on the box that the Ark is kept in. Let's take a closer look at that. Wasn't that a cool looking playset? Sure is. Look really good sitting up in here. I'm going to have to start trying to get the Indiana Jones collection. I mean, I'm a big Indiana Jones fan. Can't believe I don't have them. If you ever want an Indiana Jones figure, check out the thumb. For some reason, the thumbs break off a lot. But we're talking about the playsets. Let's look at the other playset from this line. Probably not as fun as the Well of Souls. We've got a playset of the Map Room. Let's take a look at it. The best thing about this playset is that it came with an exclusive Indiana Jones action figure. You have Indiana Jones in Arab disguise. Also with the playset was the Staff of Ra with the medallion. Also, you got another gun that came with Indy, Indy's book, a pick, a handbag, came with a lot of little pieces that you were sure to lose very quickly. That was it for the action figure and playset released in 1982, part of Series 1. But we're not done yet. Let's go to 1983 and look at what came out for Series 2. Sorry again. The figures first released in Series 1 was carried over to Series 2, but they did have some new figures added to the line. First, let's look at the Salah action figure. He comes with a torch. That's the same torch that came with the Well of Souls playset, and he has a removable robe. Series 1 is already hard to find, but Series 2 gets even harder. There was a new Indiana Jones in this line. There was a new Indiana Jones in this line also. This was Indiana Jones dressed up in disguise again, this time as a German officer. Let's take a look at it. You could also use this figure as just a German soldier, not just Indiana Jones. So this was kind of like the Stormtrooper of the Indiana Jones line, one you could build an army with. He came with a bazooka and also had the quick draw action like the Indiana Jones figure. One of the best Indiana Jones villains? I don't even think talks in the movie. Now that I think about it, I don't think he has a line. We're talking about the German mechanic. And yes, they made a figure of him. Oh, sorry. One more time. Please take me out of this chat group. Sorry about this. Let's take a look at the German mechanic. Anytime an action figure comes with a wrench, you know it's going to be a cool figure. And he also, like Indiana Jones, has the quick draw action. So with just a flick of the hand, you can have him working on his airplane. Now we know about the mail-in Belloc figure, but there was another Belloc figure that did get released on card. This was the most common. Still here. Let's look at the Belloc figure. Don't know how fun it'd be for a kid to play with an action figure that dresses like your dad, but if you wanted to, here he is. And what does he come with? Not a gun, not a whip, not even a removable hat. What does he come with? A small paper map that rolls up and you put it in his hand. Fun times. And there's one more in the action figure category, but maybe it's not a figure. Maybe it's more of a... No more texting. Let's look at the Arabian horse. Yes, they released the Arabian horse for Indiana Jones to sit on. Pretty cool horse. Let's take a look at it. And here's the horse from the Indiana Jones line. Comes with a saddle. Also, by just pressing a button, you can make his legs gallop. Although this line didn't do very well, you can tell by looking at these figures and the playset, Kenner still put their heart and soul into this line. It's a great looking line. Now let's look at the playsets for Series 2. And the first one we're going to look at is the convoy truck. Now you can have Indiana Jones in a mighty convoy rocking through the night. If you ask me, it's a pretty cool looking toy. Has a luggage rack, a tailgate, a front grill, two spare tires, two doors, rear seats. I mean, this thing is pretty cool. What kid that loved Indiana Jones wouldn't want to play with this? Now let's look at probably the lamest of all the playsets here. This one doesn't even look that appealing to kids. We're talking the streets of Cairo. All you really get here is a wheelbarrow and some baskets, but you do get a Marianne figure, kinda, and you get another exclusive figure only available in this set. Let's take a look. The best thing about the Streets of Cairo is that it comes with the Monkey Man action figure. This was the only way to get the Monkey Man. It also comes with a Marianne, but it's not really an action figure, just a hard chunk of plastic. Not only does it come with the cart and the baskets, it also comes with a monkey, just like the Marianne action figure. Well, it's different than the one that came with the Marion action figure, but it's still a monkey. And did you know this? The guy that plays the Monkey Man in Raiders of the Lost Ark also plays the guy that tries to kill Indiana Jones at the beginning of the film. You know, the one that comes up behind Indy right before they go into the cave? That guy is the same guy that plays the Monkey Man. I didn't know that for years, so I thought I'd pass that along if you didn't know it either. Now, we looked at all the figures and the playsets, but there's one more thing. Kenner did release a 12-inch Indiana Jones action figure. And although the figure looks good, it has one of the ugliest hats you'll ever see. I don't know why they thought Indiana Jones would look better with a Penitent Bear hat. Let's look at the Kenner Indiana Jones.
I've had enough of this jungle.
It's Indiana Jones, a large-size action figure.
That boulder's coming in fast.
He's new from Kenner's Raiders of the Lost Ark collection.
Stay low, Indiana. They're right behind you. Use your whip.
Whoa, I'm slipping.
Oh!
A snake pit.
Get me out of here.
Now. Indiana Jones, a large-size action figure from Raiders of the Lost Ark collection. New from Kenner.
Now, I know what you're thinking. All they did is took the Kenner Han Solo and put Indiana Jones clothes on him. Well, you are kind of right. The mold and hair and everything else is the same. However, they did change the eye color. The Kenner Indiana Jones 12-inch has blue eyes. The Han Solo has brown eyes. He came with his gun, a whip, a jacket, a shirt, pants, boots, and the ugliest, ugliest hat you'll ever see. Told you, that's one ugly hat. I even have an Indiana Jones. My Indy's way back here. I don't know if you can see him. But I missed the hat. I've got to find the hat for him. Even if it's ugly. The thing is, I had the hat. I don't know what I did with it. I can't keep up with anything. Anyway, that's a look at the Kenner Indiana Jones line. I hope you enjoyed it. Do you collect this line? Would you like to collect this line? What do you think about it? Let me know in the comments below. Every time I think about this line, I think, I want to start collecting these. But really expensive. Even loose, they're pretty expensive. Well, that's a look at the line. Thank you for watching, and I'll be back very soon with another video. Until then, please thumb up this video and subscribe to the channel. Fred, take us out of here.
Thank you, sir, for that unsolicited testimony.